This is a summary of the Cpic dosing guideline for clopidogrel and variation in the gene CYP2C19. This guideline was last updated in January 2022. Patients who are CYP2C19 poor or intermediate metabolizers have reduced platelet inhibition when treated with clopidogrel. This puts them at an increased risk of adverse cardiovascular events. The guideline therefore recommends that CYP2C19 poor metabolizers use alternative antiplatelet therapies. The guideline also recommends that an alternative antiplatelet therapy be considered for CYP2C19 intermediate metabolizers who are taking clopidogrel for acute coronary syndrome, also known as ACS, percutaneous coronary intervention, also known as PCI, or neurovascular indication. No recommendation is given for CYP2C19 intermediate metabolizers taking clopidogrel for non-ACS and non-PCI cardiovascular indications. Standard dosing of clopidogrel can be used with patients who are CYP2C19 rapid or ultra-rapid metabolizers and are being treated for ACS or PCI. No recommendation is given for CYP2C19 rapid or ultra-rapid metabolizers taking clopidogrel for non-ACS and non-PCI cardiovascular indications or for neurovascular indications. This image is adapted from the PharmGKB clopidogrel pathway. A link to the original pathway is provided in the description below this video. Clopidogrel is a prodrug that is metabolized into its active form by the enzyme CYP2C19. The active metabolites of clopidogrel inhibit the P2RY12 receptor. This results in the inhibition of platelet aggregation. CYP2C19 loss of function alleles result in impaired formation of the active metabolites of clopidogrel due to insufficient CYP2C19 enzyme activity. This results in reduced inhibition of platelet aggregation. This reduced inhibition increases the risk for serious adverse cardiovascular events that result from platelet aggregation. There are currently almost 40 defined alleles of CYP2C19, known as star alleles. Star alleles are characterized by their rate of function relative to the star 1 or star 38 alleles, which are designated as normal function alleles. Diplet types of CYP2C19 star alleles can be assigned to a metabolizer phenotype, as shown in this table and in Table 1 of the guideline. Note that, as more evidence becomes available, new star alleles can be added and the functional definition of some star alleles may change. An important caveat for all genotyping tests is that any alleles which are not detected in the assay are designated as star 1. This can include rare increased function, reduced function and non-functional alleles which are not routinely screened for in some genotyping tests. Further information about CYP2C19 alleles can also be found at the PharmVar website at www.pharmvar.org. A link to PharmVar is also given in the description below this video. CYP2C19 decreased function alleles are poorly characterized, and so the size of their impact on CYP2C19 function and drug metabolism is not well understood. As a result, patients carrying decreased function alleles are assigned as either a likely intermediate metabolizer or a likely poor metabolizer. The use of the term likely indicates that there is uncertainty in the phenotype assignment, but that it is still reasonable to use the recommendations for the confirmed phenotype. For example, it is reasonable to use the recommendations for CYP2C19 poor metabolizers for a patient assigned as a likely poor metabolizer. It is important to know that the CYP2C19 star 38 allele was recently designated as the reference allele for CYP2C19 rather than star 1. CYP2C19 star 38 matches the refseq sequence for CYP2C19, while star 1 and many other alleles contain an I331V amino acid change. These are the Cpic dosing recommendations for clopidogrel in cardiovascular indications. Patients who are CYP2C19 ultra rapid metabolizers have increased formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and lower on-treatment platelet reactivity. These patients can receive the standard dose of clopidogrel. This is a strong recommendation for patients being treated for ACS or PCI. No recommendation is given for CYP2C19 ultra-rapid metabolizers being treated for non-ACS or non-PCI cardiovascular indications. Patients who are CYP2C19 rapid metabolizers have normal or increased formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and normal or lower on-treatment platelet reactivity. These patients can receive the standard dose of clopidogrel. This is a strong recommendation for patients being treated for ACS or PCI. No recommendation is given for CYP2C19 rapid metabolizers being treated for non-ACS or non-PCI cardiovascular indications. Patients who are CYP2C19 normal metabolizers have normal formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and normal on-treatment platelet reactivity. These patients can receive the standard dose of clopidogrel. This is a strong recommendation for patients being treated for ACS, PCI, or non-ACS, non-PCI cardiovascular indications. Patients who are CYP2C19 likely intermediate metabolizers have reduced formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and increased on-treatment platelet reactivity. This puts them at an increased risk for adverse cardiac and cerebrovascular events. Clopidogrel should be avoided in these patients. This is a strong recommendation for patients being treated for ACS or PCI. No recommendation is given for CYP2C19 likely intermediate metabolizers being treated for non-ACS or non-PCI cardiovascular indications. Patients who are CYP2C19 intermediate metabolizers have reduced formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and increased on-treatment platelet reactivity. This puts them at an increased risk for adverse cardiac and cerebrovascular events. Clopidogrel should be avoided in these patients. This is a strong recommendation for patients being treated for ACS or PCI. No recommendation is given for CYP2C19 intermediate metabolizers being treated for non-ACS or non-PCI cardiovascular indications. Patients who are CYP2C19 likely poor metabolizers have significantly reduced formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and increased on-treatment platelet reactivity. This puts them at an increased risk for adverse cardiac and cerebrovascular events. Clopidogrel should be avoided in these patients. This is a strong recommendation for patients being treated for ACS or PCI, and a moderate recommendation for patients being treated for non-ACS, non-PCI cardiovascular indications. Patients who are CYP2C19 poor metabolizers have significantly reduced formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and increased on-treatment platelet reactivity. This puts them at an increased risk for adverse cardiac and cerebrovascular events. Clopidogrel should be avoided in these patients. This is a strong recommendation for patients being treated with ACS or PCI, and a moderate recommendation for patients being treated for non-ACS, non-PCI cardiovascular indications. These are the Cpic dosing recommendations for clopidogrel in neurovascular indications. No recommendation is given for CYP2C19 ultra-rapid or rapid metabolizers taking clopidogrel for neurovascular indications. Patients who are CYP2C19 normal metabolizers have normal formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and normal on-treatment platelet reactivity. These patients can receive the standard dose of clopidogrel. This is a strong recommendation. Patients who are CYP2C19 likely intermediate metabolizers have reduced formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and increased on-treatment platelet reactivity. This puts them at an increased risk for adverse cardiac and cerebrovascular events. An alternative platelet inhibitor should be considered for these patients. This is a strong recommendation. Alternative platelet inhibitors which are not impacted by CYP2C19 variation include ticagrelor and ticlopridine. Prasugrel is contraindicated in patients with a history of stroke or transient ischemic attack. Patients who are CYP2C19 intermediate metabolizers have reduced formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and increase on-treatment platelet reactivity. This puts them at an increased risk for adverse cardiac and cerebrovascular events. An alternative platelet inhibitor should be considered for these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients who are CYP2C19 likely poor metabolizers have significantly reduced formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and increased on-treatment platelet reactivity. This puts them at an increased risk for adverse cardiac and cerebrovascular events. An alternative platelet inhibitor should be considered for these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. Patients who are CYP2C19 poor metabolizers have significantly reduced formation of the active metabolite of clopidogrel and increased on-treatment platelet reactivity. This puts them at an increased risk for adverse cardiac and cerebrovascular events. An alternative platelet inhibitor should be considered for these patients. This is a moderate recommendation. Alternative platelet inhibitors which are not impacted by CYP2C19 variation include ticagrelor and ticlopidine. Prasugrel is contraindicated in patients with a history of stroke or transient ischemic attack. This guideline has been annotated on the PharmGKB website. This includes a drop-down menu where an activity summary can be given for specific combinations of alleles. The activity summary includes implications for the patient's response to clopidogrel, the appropriate dosing recommendation for the specific metabolizer phenotype, and the strength of that recommendation. Remember that variation in other genes, in addition to demographic and clinical factors, including concomitant medications, can affect treatment. It remains the responsibility of the clinician to determine the best course of treatment for a patient. Cpic and PharmGKB assume no responsibility for any injury to persons or damage to persons or property arising out of or related to any use of Cpic's guideline or for any errors or omissions. The guideline itself and supplementary information are freely available at the PharmGKB and Cpic websites. You can access relevant pages using the links in the description below this video.